So we're going to talk about getting stung. It's part of beekeeping. Every beekeeper gets stung from time to time. And I'd just like to talk to you a little bit about what a normal reaction is, how to deal with the stings, and a little bit about how we become accustomed to stings over time. So when a bee stings, it does so to defend its hive, and they're extremely good at defending their hives if they become agitated. So the bee flies out, and it goes generally to something that's moving. So if your hands are moving quickly, or if your legs are walking by a hive, it'll be going towards those moving parts. They see dark, shiny things especially well, so they'll see that movement. And for example, your eyes are dark and shiny and moving. So that's why beekeepers typically wear a veil. It protects their eyes because bees do zero in on things like your eyes and nostrils and so on. I don't like to wear a lot of protective equipment, and it's actually a good thing as a beekeeper to be getting stung on a fairly regular basis. If you're getting stung more than the average person, but less than a full-time beekeeper, you're actually at the highest risk of developing an allergy. So we recommend that people get stung on a fairly regular basis and just get used to it. So to demonstrate how a bee sting works, we'll pick up a bee here by both wings. And her abdomen contains, the stinger is right at the tip of the abdomen. It's enclosed within her abdomen right now, but when she wants to use it, she can protrude that sting, which she'll do right now. And then the sting is loosely attached to the bee, so the bee leaves that sting behind. What you can see at the surface is the venom sac, and it's pumping venom in right now through the venom shaft. So what we want to do is we want to scrape that stinger off and do that as quickly as possible. The sooner you do it, the less painful the sting is. What some beekeepers then do is puff smoke over where the sting is, because that sting leaves behind a pheromone that attracts other bees to sting in that area. So if we puff smoke on there, it masks the smell of that sting pheromone. The pain lasts about a minute. It goes away pretty quickly, so you know you can get through a minute of it. And I encourage people to just get on with doing some other work so that they're not thinking about the sting. And it's over time you get the development of these little red marks here where there's a white wheel around that. And then there may be some swelling in that location the following day. Typically beekeepers, when they first start working with bees, will swell up quite a bit. It may be your whole hand swells up with a sting, but the response is variable from person to person. Over time, your body becomes adjusted to the venom and you respond less. But usually for the first 2 or 3 years in the spring, you will swell up a little bit more, and then once you've got through that, you rarely swell at all. But again, scraping that stinger out quickly does minimize the pain, so everybody wants to do that.